Hi, and welcome to Tiger Art. I'm Mr. Hinman with another lesson at Fairview Elementary School. Today we're going to be looking at cityscapes. What is a cityscape, you might be wondering? Well, it's a special type of landscape, and a landscape is just simply a picture of an outdoor place. But when there's lots of tall buildings in it, we might call it a cityscape. Cityscapes could look like this drawing. In this drawing, what do we see? We see cars, we see people, and lights, and windows, and buildings, and streets, and sidewalks, all the things that we would think of when we see a city. But we also notice that this drawing looks a lot like it would probably in real life. There's nothing unusual about this drawing. Let's look at another one and see if we can compare them. What's different? What's the same? Let's start with things that are the same in these two cityscapes. One thing that they both have is buildings. Another thing that they both have is some color. I notice that the sky is dark in both pictures. I also notice that there's people in both pictures, and a street, and a sidewalk. What's different? One picture looks more realistic than the other picture. It looks more like it would be in normal everyday life. And the other one looks kind of cartoony. The buildings probably don't actually wiggle like that, but it's made that way because the artist wanted it to look more fun and cartoony. It gives the picture movement. When I look at this picture, I can almost hear music. It looks fun. Now let's look at this picture of a city. Here you are standing on the ground looking up. The buildings have a 3D look to them. This isn't really as hard as you would think. It's actually a little bit more simple. You can make these by drawing an arrow pointing up. After that, you would draw two lines going down from the ends of the arrow. The windows on the sides will just run in the same direction as the roof, which is that arrow, the top of the arrow. When we see a picture of a city from a distance like this, we notice that it looks like there's a line going from one side to the other, tracing along the tops of the buildings. That line is called a skyline. We would call this the city skyline. We are going to be making a painting of a beautiful city skyline today. We're going to start this project today, and we will finish it a couple days later as we add each part. Let's look at some examples of things that inspire us to make this cityscape. This is an example of a city skyline painting where we notice what we call a silhouette, and that's when a shape is just dark and you can't see any details in it, and then everything behind it is kind of lighter. It's like a shadow. So the city skyline here is a silhouette against the sky. That can inspire us to make our buildings just on flat black with a colorful sky behind it. Well, what else could we do? Could we add some bright colored rectangles on the buildings to make it look like windows at night, lit up? Absolutely, that looks neat. Could we add fireworks in the sky to add color to the picture and make it look more interesting? Absolutely. So we'll be working on some of those things today. We're going to start off today by making the silhouette of our city skyline on black paper. So today we're going to be making a cityscape. You will need a piece of black paper that's shaped like this. You will also need a white colored pencil. You need to find about halfway up on the left side of the page, so halfway between the top and bottom over on the left side, and make a little mark like this. Do the same thing on the right side, about halfway, make a little mark with white colored pencil. Those two marks is the start and the end of your skyline. You want to have one continuous line going from left to right that doesn't stop. So it comes over a little bit and then it goes up, across, and down. That is how you will make your first building. Notice that I did not draw a line across the bottom of the building because that would cut that building off. These need to be attached to the bottom. Come over a little bit more and then make a different building. You want to make something that you didn't make in the first building. So the size needs to be different. It should be a different shape, or something about it shouldn't be the same exact as the one before it. So this one I made a little bit pointier. Notice how big my buildings are. If your buildings are way too small and you are still over by the edge of the page still after two buildings, you may want to start making them a bit bigger. As we go to make the third building, I'm going to try something different than what I did the two times before. You can get creative and make your buildings a different shape if you want. You don't want to get too crazy or people won't be able to understand what they are when they look at it, but put a few shapes together, maybe like this, and see what that looks like. This time I'm not going to come down all the way. I'm going to make it look like the building is right next to this one, so there's no space in between. Then maybe skip a bigger space and make another building. Come down, not quite all the way, and make another building right next to it. I'm now up to about five buildings, and I'm just past halfway. I'm gonna make another building. This one's gonna be a different shape again. Maybe a little bigger space between this and the next one, and then I'll make four buildings together that are all so close that there's no space in between. So I ended up with about six groups of buildings. Write your name right at the bottom here, right on the front of this page. Don't do anything on the back. Keep that plain. That's important. Now comes the cutting of this project. So we're going to want to cut right on the white line. It makes it easier if you only have two pieces left in the end, though it's a little more challenging during the cutting. If you don't make extra cuts, you don't run the risk of cutting a building off. Just remember, don't cut across the bottom of a building. It needs to stay attached to what is below. After you have this cut, you should have exactly two pieces. The one that you keep has your name on it, and the one that doesn't, you throw away.